Piles of mulch from across Oahu are headed for the incinerator. It's the next step in the battle with the coconut rhinoceros beetle, a destructive pest that threatens to destroy the island's coconut trees. The beetle was discovered at Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam in December and has since been spotted as far away as Campbell Industrial Park. So how does incinerating tons of mulch help? Brent Ramadna dug deeper into the latest eradication efforts. Brent?
Joe, we talked to a rhinoceros beetle expert a few weeks back who said they were cutting down trees and looking into ways to stop this destructive beetle. Today I went back to find out how things were going and found that they may have found a way to eradicate the beetle.
Some of the green waste that the USDA has found is infested with the rhinoceros beetle.
We use it in our gardens as fertilizer. It's even used here at the base of this tree. But it turns out that mulch like this is actually a breeding ground for an invasive species here in Hawaii.
There's a few mulch piles and green waste piles, mostly on the base, that are infested with coconut rhinoceros beetle.
Rob Curtis is the pest control branch manager for the Hawaii Department of Agriculture, and his job is dealing with rhinoceros beetles. In this case, the infested piles that are located at Pearl Harbor. So how do they plan to take care of these infested piles?
Every mulch pile that we can identify, every infested tree that we can identify, we're going to destroy.
There are a few methods of destroying these piles, but the most effective is to incinerate them.
The incineration is a much faster process, and there's no chance of the incinerated materials becoming reinfested because they're gone.
Will the method you plan to use to get rid of the beetle work for the long run?
For the long run, burning will help the process. It will also help in the short term because we can get rid of these materials immediately and then they won't be available again for the beetle to reinfest.
Curtis said they are starting to see fewer beetles found in traps. And while burning these breeding areas will help, the fight is far from over.
Yeah, so destroying the mulch piles will essentially destroy the breeding sites, and it destroys the breeding cycle. And it will help. The one problem is that, like I said, this will take years, so we cannot have mulch piles around for many, many years.
Yes, you heard right. Can't have mulch piles. But it's a sacrifice Curtis said we may have to get rid of this beetle that is killing our coconut trees.
So it's kind of a double-edged sword in that we want to encourage people to be green, but at the same time, we don't want to encourage an invasive species. So for many years, we're going to have to be destroying mulch piles.
Curtis also told me that there is a proposed quarantine zone that would stretch about 50 square miles where they hope to keep the beetle contained as they continue to burn and get rid of these mulch piles. But they are still in discussion about the area. Brent Ramadnik, KHON 2 News.